Station City in Hollywood. It's the Carol Burnett Show, brought to you by your local Quality Buick dealer. Wouldn't you really rather have a Buick?
My cold is getting worse.
All right. Let me have a listen. All right. A bit of a respiratory distress there?
Yes, I think so.
Oh, you hastened?
Yes, come in, come in.
It's almost curtain time, Jim, and we have another full house.
Oh, this is my co-star, Sir Lawrence Redgood. This is Dr. Talbot.
Doctor?
Yes, I have a cold.
A cold? Oh, this room is full of germs.
I'm afraid it's much more than just a cold. Miss Fontaine has the flu.
The flu? Oh, this is dreadful.
Oh, don't worry. I plan on going on as always. There's no way you can keep me off the stage.
No? Why tonight of all nights when there's a big producer that's flown all the way from Hollywood to watch my performance?
We'll give him a show that he'll never forget.
I'm sure I'll catch something.
Miss Fontaine, if you insist on going on this evening, I'm going to have to give you a shot.
Oh, where, Doctor?
Take a bow.
Places, everyone.
Oh, thank God. I have to go.
No, the shot. Miss Fontaine, we've got to have the shot.
There we are. Champagne for one. Music. Soft lights. Is that you, Stella?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Stella, my darling, my precious, my love.
Oh, Rodney.
I've missed you, my sweet. How are you?
I'm doing well, thank you. I really couldn't be better.
You've never looked so radiant.
Oh, thank you. I've missed your kisses. It's torture. Come, kiss me. Kiss me passionately.
There!
Your kisses, they drive me wild. I love this room, and I love this room.
Yes, it is beautiful.
So far away from everyone, so high above everything.
Come to me, Stella.
Rodney, you said there was something you wanted to tell me on the phone.
Yes, but first let's have some champagne.
All right.
To us.
To us, darling. Well, get on with it. What was it?
I spoke to John last night.
My husband?
Yes, I think he knows about us. Cigarette?
Yes. Yes. What makes you think that he suspects us?
Oh, just the way he was talking.
Well, there's no telling what he if I do, he could try to one more time kill you.
Do you think he would go that far?
He's got a violent temper. There's just no saying what might happen.
Have you asked him for a divorce?
Oh, dozens of times. But he said he'd never let me go. Never, never, never.
I can't give you up, Stella. Kiss me, my darling.
Oh, pardon me. Forget it, forget it.
There they are, Stella. We can't just wipe away 3 years of our lives.
Dear, but we can't go on like this, sneaking around behind everyone. Waiting to see if we get found out. It's not fair to you, it's not fair to me.
I think we should tell John about us and just take the consequences.
No! No!
He can't hurt you!
You're telling what he...
You've just ruined my Hollywood deal.
I'm sorry. I really can't help it.
Remember that song Stella was playing the first night we met?
Oh, yes. Oh, let's dance to it like we did that night. Dancing with you, it always makes me so weak.
And finally, I've caught you.
You've killed her, murderer.
I suppose it's late for an apology.
Get out. Stella, my darling, Stella. We had so much to live for, and now it's all over. I can't bear the thought of life without you, but I must face it somehow. You were so, so warm, so loving. And now you're gone. 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 To think of such vitality cut off in the prime of life. A woman with such a lust for living to live no more. Her youthful laughter to be still and never heard from again. Farewell, my love. Cotton! You've ruined me!
Way home from Campbelltown. Been 2 weeks gone and he thought he'd stop and whips and having a drink before he went home to her. And Wolo said hello. He said, hi, what's it doing? Wolo said, sit down, I got some bad news, it's gonna hurt. He said, I'm your best friend and you know that's right. You're no bride, ain't home tonight. She's been gone, she's been seeing that ace boy sick. Well, he got mad and he saw red. And he said, boy, don't lose your head, cause to tell you the truth, I've been wicking myself. That's a night that the lights went out in Georgia. And he left the bar, walking on home cause he didn't live far. See, and he didn't have many friends, and he just lost him one. Brother thought his wife must have left town, so he went home and finally found the only thing his papa had left him, and that was a gun. went off to Andy's house, slipping through the backwoods, quiet as a mouse. Came upon some tracks too small for Andy to make. He looked through the back porch door, and he saw Andy lying on the floor in a puddle of blood, and he started to shake. Well, the Georgia Patrol was making their rounds, so he fired a shot just to flag him down. And a big bear sheriff grabbed his gun and said, "What you doing?" And the gentleman said, "Guilty in a make-believe trial." Slapped the sheriff on the back with a smile, said, "Supper's waiting at home, and I gotta get to it." The tracks he saw along his way to Andy's house and back that night were mine. His cheating wife, she never left town. That's one body that'll never be found. See, little sister don't miss when she aims a gun. That's the night that the lights went out in Georgia.
Welcome to the Early Early Show. Tonight we present another cornball classic, a stirring saga of army nurses in war. So Proudly We Heal, starring Claudette Strong as the heart-driving combat nurse who gave everyone medical treatment, advice, and a pain in the neck. And Lana Lark as the socialite nurse to whom suffering was getting a bad table at the Stark Club. And Elizabeth Ninney as the neurotic young nurse who went overseas to find herself and maybe a husband. And introducing World War II as itself.
Take it easy, soldier. You're gonna be all right.
They just kept coming, one after the other.
Try not to think about
it. You need me, Captain?
Yes, Miss Park Avenue. I had an emergency. You should have been here.
Well, I had an emergency, too.
What happened?
My hair dryer broke.
Listen, Lieutenant. You should have been here. This is war. This man was wounded in hand-to-hand combat. He was bayoneted, hit with a rifle butt, and shot.
Did the Japanese attack us?
No. He's the company cook.
Oh.
Can I go lie down now, nurse?
Yeah, go ahead. Stay off your feet and out of the kitchen.
Well, if you don't need me, Captain, I guess I'll go back to my tent and just take a nap.
You go on ahead. I'll be all right.
Captain, when's the last time you had any sleep?
Just before Pearl Harbor.
Captain, you really need to get some sleep.
Maybe you're right. Oh, there. That's much better.
You call that sleep?
Yes, and I had the most wonderful dream. I dreamed the lights came on all over the world, and there were bluebirds across the white cliffs of Dover.
Ah! Well, they're getting closer!
Yes, and we have no doctors, we have no medical supplies, our food supply is gone, and three Japanese divisions are closing in on us. Do you know what this means?
I guess the dance is called off tonight?
Ha! Ha! Tell your emperor it takes more than that to break the game. We need more help. Where's the backup they promised us?
I don't know. Hi, I'm the nice young new nurse. I thought I'd have a nurse break down and then wash up. Thanks. I needed that. What are we gonna do? We gotta hold them off. I gotta date with the colonel tonight.
Is that all you ever think about is men, men, men? Is it? Is it? Is it?
Well, yes, yes, yes.
First and foremost, you are a nurse.
I am not just a nurse. Under this uniform, I am a woman. I have needs, I have passions and desires. What about you, Captain? What do you got under that uniform?
Another uniform.
You know what you are, Captain. You're just an iceberg in a khaki training bra.
I'm getting closer and closer! There's nothing to be afraid of.
Yes, there is. I think my jaw is fractured.
Those GIs in there need me. I'm going to go in there and give them the inspiration they so rich. Hi there, kid from Brooklyn. Hello there, frightened young man who became a man overnight. Hi there, grizzled young sergeant who knows there's no atheists in foxholes. Hi there, harmonica player who's driving everyone up their wall with your lousy playing. Hey there, dog face.
Look who's tough.
I see you got a letter from home. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I bet I know who this is from. Would you like me to read it to you?
No, Captain, that's all right.
Oh, if I can bring you just a little bit of pleasure and happiness. Dear John, by the time you read this letter, I'll be out of your life forever. Remember Alvin, the 4F, who everyone made fun of? Well, he and I, yeah, I think that's enough. Take care. Hello. Good looking.
Hi, dog face.
How's the wound?
Starting to hurt a little.
Oh, that's too bad. Where is it?
In that shoulder.
Where are you from, kid?
I'm from Iowa, ma'am, and golly, Lord, I ever miss the good old U.S. of A. Mama's apple pie, the corner drugstore, and hot dogs and chocolate milkshakes, and the cry, play ball, and the walking down Main Street saying hi neighbor, and the 4-H meetings and the square dances and milking my old cow Emily, and oh, my faithful dog Mike, and my good old tractor Marvin, and the planting and the plowing and the harvesting, and waving to the engineer on the good old Atchison, Topeka, and the Santa Fe.
You need to take a rest.
But my shoulder's fine.
It's your mouth that needs a rest.
Let me alone. I don't need no medical attention. I need to get through the enemy lines and deliver a dispatch.
It's okay, then I'll take it from here. Sit down. You're worried about those wounds.
Ah, these ain't wounds. I got a few bayonet stabs, a pound or two of grapnel, and 5 or 6 bullet holes. Ain't nothing.
But you're bleeding.
Oh, that I didn't know.
You just sit right here. I'll take care of you.
I ain't got time for that. I gotta deliver this dispatch.
But don't you understand? If you don't get emergency treatment right now, you might bleed to death.
All right, but hurry it up.
I'll do it as fast as I can. Yeah, all better.
Oh, you saved my life.
Oh, dear.
Cindy.
What a crazy ball.
Forget about it. It'll never work. We're from two different worlds.
No, we'll make it work somehow, baby.
Sure. Let's talk about it again when I get back from this suicide mission.
Okay, yeah. Take this.
Well, what is it?
It's an aspirin. Now, you're hurt, and you need to stay here. Why don't you stay here, and I'll go in your place?
No! I ain't gonna let the woman I love deliver herself into danger for me. I'm gonna...
You
really love that big palooka, don't you?
I do, Captain. I want something that... I was wrong being a spoiled rich brat and just trying to be all cute and sexy and feminine and all. I need to be more like you.
Thanks. I needed that. But I can't let you go. You stay. I'll go.
No, 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 Captain. You stay. I'll go.
Okay. You win. I hate to do this to you.
Oh.
Go on, young lovers. All I ask is you can think of me once in a while.
Captain, you can't go like that. You'll have to fight your way through the lines.
Oh, you're right.
Do you realize what you're doing? It's still not too late to change your mind.
No. No. Even though the world will little note nor long remember that we have nothing to fear but fear itself, from sea to shining sea, that this great land of ours, one nation, indivisible, all praising the Lord and passing the ammunition.
That's beautiful.
Thanks. I just have one regret.
What's that?
That I didn't think of this before. See you later, kid. Keep your powder dry.
Hey, there's something sticking out of that one.
Oh, no.
Wait. You held it and keep it to think of me.
Better take it with you, Captain. You may need it.
Is not enough. Look out, Kojo! Here I come!
There goes the bravest woman I ever known. You're right. Nobody will ever replace her. Nobody! Nobody! She'll be an inspiration to every GI in khaki, to every gob in blue, to every defense fucker and every air raid.
Feeling very proud.
You're singing far too loud.
I before we go insane. A song awakens my fears.
Now, no, it was just some people singing. Anyways, I know I'm jealous. Oh, if Harry's a minute late from work, I'm worried he's with another woman. Oh, the curse being married to the handsomest man in the world. Oh, I'm losing my mind. Okay, all right, Mom. I'll try to control myself. Bye. Oh, Harry! Oh, Harry! Oh, you missed me too!
You with those 5 points of stairs.
Oh, kiss me, Harry. You're handsome. Oh, kiss me, kiss me.
Please, Granny, take it easy. It's 98 degrees outside. I don't need your hot breath all over me.
Oh, but it's been 8 hours and 12 minutes and 32 seconds since I last saw you.
All right. What is this one?
Oh. Oh, come on, Harry.
Now, if I asked you once, I told you 1,000 times, don't muss my hair.
How was work today, dear?
It was all right. You finally gave me a new garbage truck.
Oh, a new garbage truck. That's wonderful, Harry.
Not really. Something missing from the garbage business. No challenge in it anymore. I'm gonna have a drink before dinner.
Not till the very end. Buried her under her maiden name.
You're sick, Skylar.
Cheers.
I'm so nervous for Daddy to meet Donald. I think this may be my last chance. I mean, compared to you, I'm so plain, and you're just so extremely handsome.
Oh, that's not true. I'm incredibly handsome.
You have those fabulous legs and that magnificent sense of style, and your cheekbones are just, oh.
I do take after Uncle Henry. He was a Sid-filled Follies girl.
You're sick, Skylar.
Oh, chin up, Bobo.
Bobo? I'm more of a boo-boo than a Bobo.
Okay, well, I gotta go. I gotta go to the beauty parlor.
What for?
A donation.
Okay. Mr. Donald Crowley's here. Okay, you can just send him in.
Okay, thank you.
It's so hard to get ugly help. Donald!
Hi, Bobo.
Oh, hi! Mwah! Mwah! Come sit! How was the doctor?
Well, I don't know. I'm waiting to see. Today they tested me for pollen, wool, dust, and a kefir.
Kefir? That seems very thorough. Well, how are you feeling?
A little strange. I hope I'm not having a reaction to the test.
Oh, I hope that you're not either, but to be frank, I'm I'm so nervous for you to meet Dad.
There's nothing to be nervous about. It doesn't bother me. It'll be all right.
Oh, what did you say?
Oh, I said it'll be all right.
No, before that.
It doesn't bother me.
Oh, well, I just hope everything goes well for when Daddy's here.
Don't worry. What could happen?
Donald!
I don't know why I just did that. I suddenly have an uncontrollable urge to lick my hand.
Okay, well, don't do that in front of Father. Why don't you just come and sit over here on this chair and I'll go get Dad.
All right.
Oh! Donald! What?
I don't know why I did this either. It must have something to do with those darn tests.
Well, okay. You have to contain yourself and get down off that chair. Scat! Scat! What now, Donald?
I think I'm shedding.
Oh, okay. Oh, Daddy, this is Donald. Donald, this is Daddy.
Bobo?
Yes, Daddy?
There's a lot to be said for being an old maid.
Let's just sit down. Why don't we just sit down together? Oh.
So, you want to marry my daughter?
Yes, sir.
And you want to marry that?
I do.
You understand I'm very particular about who and what marries into my family.
Oh, Donald knows, Daddy. Donald knows.
Right.
Donald, what's the matter now?
I think it's please.
Oh, Daddy, Donald has this old tennis injury. I just have to sometimes work the cricks out of his neck. Would you like something to drink?
Yes, a double. Oh, I'll get it myself.
Okay.
Could you get me a drink of water? I think I have something caught in my throat.
Certainly, but what is it?
What?
Be familiar with one's pride in one's family name, but my family is a very select stock. We're acknowledged leaders of the 400. My ancestors go all the way back to the Mayflower. We represent the epitome of aristocratic tradition, and I would like to think that my son-in-law could take his place in society alongside me. Bobo.
Yes, Daddy?
Can I have a word with you, alone? Man to man.
That sounds great. One, we talked to Donald. Hey, Donald. Dad wants to just talk, just the two of us. So. Okay. Let me try this. Let's try this. Dad, I don't know what to say. He's not normally like this. I think it must be a reaction to the drugs or the allergy tests or whatever they're doing to him. Please let me marry him. You've always wanted a grandson.
I suppose you'll give me a pick of the litter.
Please let me, for my sake.
Oh, all right. If you can catch it.
Donald! Donald! Here, kitty! Oh!
That was kind of fun. Never played with yarn before.
Do sit down, Mr. Crowley. I'm sure everything will be all right, son.
It certainly will be, sir.
Well, I have some great news. Daddy said we could get married.
Oh, that's wonderful. Sir, I don't quite know what's come over me tonight, but I can assure you it's only temporary.
You will stay for dinner tonight, won't you?
Oh, gosh. Thank you so much.
Oh, no. Not the goldfish. Not the goldfish. Not the goldfish.
Look, I hate to be a bother. I'm actually not very hungry. I'm just gonna head along home and open up myself a can of Friskies.
Can you stay for dinner?
No. I'm embarrassed you enough now. I'm going out that door, and the next time you see me, I'm gonna be completely normal. Good night.
Good night, Donald.
Molly. Take a deep breath. I said deep, not last.
Want to sit out for a little bit?
Oh, maybe.
Well, make up your mind. I don't want to take that long walk for nothing.
Oh, all right, all right. What's that perfume you're wearing?
Citronella. Keeps us mosquitoes away.
Oh, you're wearing enough to keep Dracula away. Oh, yeah. Give me a push, will you?
Oh. You might have started for me, will you?
Want to do anything?
Well, what do you have in mind?
That give you a thrill?
Whew, sure does.
Seriously, Molly, give you a thrill?
Thrill? I thought you said chill.
You know, Molly, I've been thinking, we're going to go on a second honeymoon while there's still time.
Time for what?
Remember our first honeymoon?
We went to Niagara Falls.
We was just starting out.
So was Niagara Falls.
Tell me something, Molly. You gonna marry again when I'm gone?
Well, I haven't yet.
Oh, really, Molly? You gonna marry again?
Yep. I'm gonna get myself a 40-year-old gigolo.
Well, go ahead. Won't be the same.
Well, I sure hope not.
You really know how to hurt a guy, don't you?
Oh, it's just joshing you, Bert. Did you see the doctor today?
Yeah.
What'd he say?
Give me a complete examination.
What'd he say you had besides insomnia?
Well, he put a stethoscope to my chest.
Then what?
Didn't hear anything.
Well, no news is good news.
And then I crossed my legs and he tapped me on the knee.
Then what?
Told me to come back when it moved.
Ooh-wee. Anything in the paper?
I don't know. Let me see. These rubber bands are getting stronger and stronger. Well, let's see here. Well, look here. They opened a new pizza parlor in the retirement village.
Oh, that's nice.
They got a special today.
Oh, what is it?
Strained pizza. Well, here's a news item. It says fluoridation keeps your teeth from falling out.
Fluoridation? Must be some new kind of glue.
Yeah. Molly, I'm getting restless.
What do you want to do?
Well, we could hop in the car and go up to Lover's Lane.
Well, there's no full moon.
Well, that's true. It'd be too dark to watch anybody.
Well, let's just head upstairs.
Oh, then what?
Well, let's see if you survive that first. Help me up.
Oh, all right. Oh, you and that sweater. tell me something, Molly. You gonna take a bath tonight?
No, it's too cold. I'd get goosebumps.
That's better than nothing.
Get up there, cool.
The Carol Burnett Show has been brought to you by Carol Burnett Show. Extra long and full thin, so it travels the smoke farther for greater miles. Puff per puff, taste mild.
Now he's out, get out of place.
Agony! Agony, did I tell you?
Mr. Cross, you're doing okay.
Put my body back in bed.
That's good. I'll try some more tomorrow. Oh,
thank you, nurse.
You're welcome, doctor.
Oh, I thought she'd never go.
Reaching it up. Okay. Let's see here.
You got back pains.
Right.
Whiplash.
Yep.
You got a leg injury.
Yeah.
And shock.
And don't forget the headaches and the double vision.
Right.
I'll never forget you for this, man.
How could you forget me? I'm your brother-in-law.
I know, and as soon as I settle with the insurance company, I want to take you and sis to the Bahamas on vacation.
Well, why not? I'll have plenty of free time after I lose my license.
Who's gonna know? They settle these things in a minute. It's $250,000 to a big insurance company.
Well, I'll tell you what, buddy. I'll check in on you tomorrow.
All right, thanks, Pop.
Take care.
Come in.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Alice Portnoy of the Fireside Girls, so I'm with Troop 66.
Oh, what is this, kid? I'm in terrible pain.
But I'm here to collect funds from the private ward to buy things like sweets and flowers and magazines for those in the charity ward.
Some other time, kid. I'm a very sick man.
I'm sorry to hear that you're so sick, sir. Is there anything I can do to help?
You could just go away.
Oh, well, I do have my merit badge and first aid. I'm certified in everything but mouth-to-mouth resuscitation.
All right, kid. Here's a nickel. Now, beat it.
Oh, a whole nickel. I can buy half a Tootsie Roll with that.
Would you mind? My doctor said I need to avoid excitement, and you're getting on my last pinched nerves.
This is your chart, sir. I can see why you've been prescribed, peace and quiet with whiplash, shock, headaches, and double vision.
Yeah, I got hit. I got hit by a truck.
Oh, well, that's not quite how I remembered it, sir.
What are you talking about?
Well, I was walking a little old man across the street and I saw the whole thing.
You saw the runaway truck with the drunk driver that blew through the red light and hit me in the crosswalk, right?
I missed that. I did see you, though, step off the curb in front of a don't walk sign and throw yourself in front of a stalled vehicle.
You're an adorable girl with a wonderful sense of humor. Here's a quarter.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Run along.
I promise I won't tell a soul, not even my police uncle.
You know, I'm going to give you all the change I've got in my wallet, and you... Just, let's, don't go repeating that adorable story you told me.
Okay? I won't, sir. Oh, well, I hope that you sleep well, sir.
Oh, I will. Good night.
Oh, well, before I go, I think I should probably make sure you're okay with your neck brace.
I'm fine.
Are you sure, sir? Are you sure
there's
nothing
I'm certain.
That makes sense. Nothing I can do to help you, sir?
No.
Well, congratulations, sir. I think that I've cured your whiplash.
What?
You see, you moved your head like this, and then you moved your head like this. I think you can take off that collar, and I can call the nurse.
Wait. I'll tell it myself later, but in the meantime, why don't you take this crisp, brand new $5 bill, and continue the wonderful work you're doing. Goodbye, sweetheart.
That's very nice of you. I guess I hope you sleep well.
Oh, I will.
Don't let the bedbugs bite.
I won't.
And be sure to give my regards to your brother-in-law, the doctor.
All right. I will.
You see, sir, I have a habit of listening to the door before I enter, not so as not to wake a sleeping patient.
You know, kid, I'm going to give you all the money in my pocket. $30. Now, why don't you just run along and forget you ever saw me, okay?
Sir?
Now what?
According to my calculations, you've given the Fireside Girls $35 and some change.
And that's a lot of money, isn't it?
Well, it is a lot of money unless you're comparing it to $250,000 payout from the insurance
company. I don't believe this!
If I might be so bold, sir, I would suggest that you give 30% to the doctor, 30% to your lawyer, 30% to the Fireside Girls, and you keep a big, fat 10%. How does that strike you?
I think strike is the right word. It's what I'm gonna do when I get my hands on you. I'm gonna give you a lesson you'll never forget.
To the man from AAA.
Oh, thank you for charging my battery.
Sign of here, lady.
I certainly do appreciate the emergency service.
Yeah, just remember us, you know, if you ever get a car.
Oh, it's amazing what they do for only $66 a year. Now then, Estelle, where were we?
Oh. I believe I was crying hysterically and you were trying to comfort me.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Shall we take it from there?
Okay.
There, Estelle. Control yourself. Whatever is the problem?
No, Marion, it's horrible. I feel so ashamed.
Go on.
Marion, can you keep a secret?
I promise you, whatever you tell me will not go outside this area code.
Well, Marion, I wouldn't admit this to anyone in the whole world, but I'm a...
You're a what?
I'm a werewolf.
More coffee, Estelle. Now... Dear, what makes you think you're a werewolf?
Well, because when the moon is full, strange things happen to me. Horrible things. Oh!
Like that.
Because when the moon is full, I break into bakeries and grocery stores and delicatessens. I become this wild animal looking for food. Oh, Marion, last night was the worst. The worst. There I was, 3 o'clock in the morning, baying. Oh!
Baying at the moon.
Oh, no. At this big bucket of chicken going around and around and around in the sky.
Don't be frightened, it's just the door.
Oh, I'm not afraid. Maybe it's the Girl Scouts with thin mints.
Hello, who are you?
Mother, don't you recognize me?
Give me another hint.
Mother, I'm your daughter.
establishment, and I've been living on a commune.
Oh, how meaningful.
Yeah, they even initiated me.
Oh, that must have been some initiation.
Well, take care of it for me. I gotta go.
Goodbye, Joyce.
Oh, no, the anarchist gave me a new name. It's Running Deer now.
Oh, well, next time, run a little faster, Deer. All right, so where were we?
Oh, Mary, you don't know the half of it. Last Tuesday, I broke into an Italian restaurant. And in one gulp, I ate 6 large pizzas, 3 orders of lasagna. Oh, and this spicy meatballs.
Oh, mamma mia. Oh.
And dessert. I hijacked a bakery truck.
Oh, why, Estelle, why?
Oh, that devil's food cake made me do it, Marion.
There.
Marion, what am I going to do?
Oh, you need to seek professional guidance and counseling. Have you spoken with Rabbi Myron Feldman?
Oh, I haven't seen a good rabbi since he became a golf nut.
Oh. I'll get it. Oh, Rabbi Feldman, come in.
My favorite chick, son. How are you, my dear?
I'm fine, Rabbi. You know Estelle, of course.
Why, yes, indeed I do. A devout member of our congregation and co-captain of the majority.
Oh, what brings you by today, Father? Rabbi?
Well, I have arranged to have a rendezvous here with my fellow man of the cloth and golfing buddy, Father Colucci.
Oh, get it. I wonder who that could be. Oh, it's Father Colucci. You know the Paul's long ball hitting trees.
Hello, Marion. Hello,
Myron. Oh, you know Estelle.
Oh, Estelle, my favorite yenta.
Oh, why don't we all sit down?
Yes. So, how's the good rabbi? I invited you to our Brotherhood Week dinner.
I was just about to as you rang the bell. Actually, it will be a most prestigious and swanky affair. I myself have designed the centerpiece, symbolic of Brotherhood.
Yeah, it's a bust of Danny Thomas and chopped liver.
The nose alone weighs 12 pounds.
Oh, well, I'll buy a ticket.
Well, me too.
Well, Myron, we should be off to the golf course.
Most certainly, Francis. I have one small favor to ask of you today, though. Please, try not to rattle your beads while I'm putting.
Oh, and while I'm putting, try not to yell to my caddy, "Hey, am I gonna go ill for you?"
What caddy? I was talking to you. A little theological humor, my dear.
Yeah, well, we must be off, my.
Yes, if we don't meet now, we'll be playing by moonlight.
Oh!
My dear Estelle, as my brother the doctor would say, why not have a glass of seltzer?
Oh, it wouldn't help.
Well, it wouldn't help.
Actually, I'm afraid things are more serious than that. Estelle has become the town werewolf.
Oy vey. That's my line. A Jewish werewolf. Sammy Davis Jr., Will Potts.
It's not even dark outside yet. And I think I'm having a spell. Oh!
Oh, stand back. I think she's dangerous.
Wait, I have something to say.
What is it that Rabbi Feldman has to say? What about Estelle, the werewolf? During the next full moon, will she be hunted down by a safari from Sara Lee? And what about Marion's runaway daughter? Will she remain running deer or become running joke? And what about Father Colucci and Rabbi Feldman? Will they hit the bestseller list with their book, There Are No Atheists in Sand Traps? And what about Marion herself? Will her relationship with the man from AAA continue, or has he seen enough wrecks already? For the answers to these and other trivial questions, tune in tomorrow as the stomach turns.
Just to have you.